I am.
I am.
I am.
I am.
I am.
Let me tell you the truth. You will know who you are and what you're here to do when you know who Jesus is and what he was here to do. For if you can't know yourself unless you first know your Maker, then you must know Jesus, who is the perfect image of our Creator. And if you can't know your purpose unless you first know why God made you, then you must know Jesus, who is the only one who only did what the Father created him to do. So, the question must be asked, who is Jesus, and what was his task? Well, for starters, Jesus is the Son of God, the visible image of the invisible one, which already tells us a whole lot about who we are. For if God has a son, then we know God has a family, and if the son became like us, it means God wants us to join his dynasty. So the very first thing we learn about our own beings by looking to Christ is that who we are is desired by the Creator of life. And we can also see what this desire is like, because if the invisible one became visible, then his love for us must be one of great might. So, in light of this gleaming, we also learn about our being that we are so loved that God became like us. So, you want to know who you are? You are loved by a God who wants you in his home. You are desired by a God who spared no effort, distance, or bone, for he came for you. And this is where his and our purpose is shown, that Jesus came to seek and save the lost by making himself known. So, you want to know what your purpose is? You want to know what you are here to do? You are here to continue the mission of the one who came here to save you. Your purpose is to be sent. Your being is to tell the one story about the one man that can save every living thing from the punishment of hell. Who are you? You are the hands and feet of Jesus. What are you here to do? To use those limbs to point to him, the one who became flesh and freedom.